Hey everybody, John Wagnon here with DevCentral. We're coming to you with another Lightboard lesson video. And today we're going to talk about web application firewalls. We did a series recently on the OWASP top 10 security risks out there in the world today that would affect your web applications. And in some of those, you know, we talked about the need for a WAF, a web application firewall, WAF, and maybe how that could help protect your web applications. So today I wanted to dig into what is a WAF and why do you need it. So just to draw a couple of quick things up here, let's say you have your awesome web application. So over here, you know, here's your web app that everybody comes and visits and it's awesome and it does all kinds of great stuff. And so that's what you want to protect. Well, you have clients out here or users. I'll just put, you know, here's a client out here that wants to access ultimately your web application, and that's great and all. If you had nothing but great, you know, safe clients and users that access your web application, the problem is not all clients are great. You know, some are these attacker bad guys. So let's say you have an attacker that wants to also visit your web application for less than positive reasons. The question is, how do you protect your web application against these attacks? There's a couple of things, you know, from an overall security, you know, approach that you can use to protect your web application. And the first thing that I'll mention is a standard, what we'll call a standard or network firewall. So let me put that down here. So I'll say network, and then I'll just put FW for firewall. Alrighty. Typically, a standard network firewall lives at layers like 3 and 4. And these, you know, your typical network firewall is going to do things like IP protection, you know, from an IP address perspective, maybe like port, you know, protection, that kind of thing. It uses things like access control lists, ACLs. That is your standard network firewall. So if a client or an attacker or whoever it is comes into your web application on IP address whatever or port number whatever as a destination port, then your network firewall can block those or they can let them in. And your typical layer 3-4 network firewall does a great job of handling that level of, you know, of access in your web application. The problem, though, is that you need more than just that, because there are other attacks that I'll put up here, and this is where a web application firewall comes into play. And these are at the higher layers, so like layer 4 through 7 or 5 through 7 is where the web application firewall lives and really does great things for you. So some things that a WAF would be able to help out with are things like, let's say, an HTTP flood attack. So I'll put flood up here. There's another attack, and these are some specific things that I'm mentioning right now, I know, but you can understand in general. Things like Slowloris is a specific attack that would come in at the higher layers on, you know, on your stack, that a traditional network firewall is never going to be able to block or would not block based on what its functionality is. Alrighty, so from a like an HTTP flood, for example, or a Slowloris attack, these are attacks that present a legitimate HTTP request to your web application. It's going to pass through any network firewall. I mean, given that it's on, you know, an IP and port that's allowed through the firewall, but let's say that that's true, then the actual nature of the attack itself is not to attack the network itself, but rather to attack the web application. So again, these are legitimate HTTP requests that are coming specifically at your web application that a traditional network firewall is not going to stop. I'll also put, let me put OWASP top 10 up here. Alrighty. The OWASP top 10, and we did a whole series on these things. There are things like injection attacks, cross-site scripting. There's 10 of them. You know, there's a lot of these that are out there, these security risks. And the web application firewall is frankly designed to look at those types of security risk on the OWASP top 10 and to mitigate as many of those as possible. It can't mitigate all of them because some of them are like the number 10 one is insufficient logging and monitoring. So that's where you just need to log your stuff or you need to monitor your applications properly. And so it doesn't stop, a WAF is not going to stop every one of the top 10, but it's going to do a great job at most of them. One of the other things that I would mention is, you know, when you talk about web application security, the ultimate answer in terms of someone that would say, well, hey, why do I even need a web application firewall? Obviously, what I just mentioned is true. The fundamental answer, though, is you need to design and build your web applications securely. So if you did that, if you designed your web application securely, where a cross-site scripting, you know, attack were to try to happen, or an injection attack or some sort of untrusted user input was going to be, you know, brought against your web application and do some nefarious thing, then if you built it correctly, then you could try to, or you could block a lot of those just by designing and building your web application properly. But we live in the real world today, and there are a lot of applications that are just not built properly, or they're legacy applications that even though they did a great job at the time they were built, things have moved or things have progressed and they're not secure anymore. So instead of just maybe one web application, let's say, you know, you have, let's say this is a representation of your web application. Let's say you have, you know, 100 of these things back here. You got tons of them that you have to protect. And each one is designed differently. Each one is, you know, handled separately, all that kind of stuff. So how in the world are you going to take every single one of your unique web applications and modify those, configure those, and all that so that they can handle all of these higher layer attacks that would be launched against them? And the answer is, if you put a WAF or a web application firewall in front of the web applications, then you can configure the web application firewall and it will handle all of the attack stuff against all of these applications. You don't have to go back there and handle all of these separately. Ideally, of course, you do want to make sure that they're configured properly and all that. But that's one of the reasons that you would need a WAF as well. So one other thing that I'll mention is the HTTP protocol that our web applications today just live and die by was never really designed for the complex web applications that we have in play today. So while you might say, well, hey, let's just handle this at the protocol level, at the HTTP level, unfortunately, HTTP, you know, when it was designed, it was not designed with, again, these complex applications in mind. And so there are fundamental protocol level vulnerabilities or you know, weaknesses, as it were, that can be exploited. Again, that's where a web application firewall can come in and say, hey, as a what would have been a legitimate HTTP request coming into my web application, as that comes in, I'm going to inspect that. I'm going to check it out, make sure it's not an injection attack. It's not a cross-site scripting attack. It's not a HTTP flood or Slowloris or any number of things. Because if it is, I'm going to block it right here at the web application firewall. If it's not, if it passes all these checks, then I'll go ahead and let that request come back to my web application and let the response come back like it needs to. So those are several things to consider as you look at the web application firewall. And as you may answer the question, you know, hey, I've already got a network firewall. Why do I need a web application firewall? The network firewall, again, is handling the lower layers of this, you know, the OSI model, the network stack, whereas the web application is these higher layers that still see attacks, but that they would never, you know, that a traditional network firewall would never catch. So hopefully you've learned a couple of things about what a web application firewall is, what it is designed to handle, why it's important. F5, we have our own version of the web application firewall. It does great things. You can get out there and check it out. But you know, at its fundamental core, you need to make sure you have a web application firewall in addition to a standard network firewall. So thanks for liking or thanks for watching this Lightboard lesson today. Hey, if you enjoyed this one, you can click on the DC ball right here and subscribe to our YouTube channel. And we will see you guys out there in the community.